Hey everyone, welcome to another great episode of the Smooth Business Growth Podcast, where we share 15 minutes of fast-paced, pure marketing strategies proven to move the needle in your business. So I'm your host and Captain Lindsay Phillips, and I am the founder of Smooth Sailing Business Growth, where we help busy entrepreneurs attract and acquire customers faster through powerful and consistent content marketing. In fact, if you go to smoothbusinessgrowth.com, you can actually download your social media roadmap to help you do just that. But for now, we're going to get to some really good stuff here because today we're chatting with internationally acclaimed keynote speaker Kelly Roach. She has worked with some of the most world's largest organizations, revealing her simple systems and strategies for explosive business growth. She is the sales queen, baby. So let's set sail so she can share her launch secrets. So welcome aboard.
Oh my gosh. Thanks for the intro. How amazing is that? I hope I can live up to it.
Oh, of course you can. You are the queen, lady. I've seen you speak in action and, you know, I'm obviously connected with you anyway. So I see how you are just absolutely crushing it out there. And such a polished and graceful way. I can't say enough good things about you.
Thank you so much.
So when we say launch, I mean, some people, they kind of get it, they kind of don't. So how would you explain what a launch is or who does them, really?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, I think anybody that has a product, program, or service that they want to create big bursts of income growth quickly can utilize a launch, which is basically a very intense focus on opening up the sales of that particular product, program, or service for a very limited time to get a group of customers to say yes all at once versus the slow trickle that you would get all year long organically anyway.
Absolutely. And yeah, you kind of touched upon how much work goes into it. And yes, I've been a part of a few and there is so much work. Now, what is the typical launch? Like, I know many people know about the sideways sales letter approach. Can you touch upon that and why it's not necessarily the go-to approach anymore?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, you know, here's the thing, you know, you hear and see online all the time, you know, people sharing about this $1 million launch or this huge, massive, you know, sales growth that they had all at once. And a lot of times, Lindsay, if you took out all the costs of the team members needed to facilitate that launch, the time spent by the CEO or business leader to set that launch up, and then the affiliates that were paid to promote that launch, when you peel all the layers back of the actual profits in these big, massive launches that are done in the traditional sense, there's little to no profit left for the actual business. So it's great for vanity's sake, not so great for sanity's sake. And so, you know, for me, Lindsay, I'm always looking at what is the fastest, most efficient path to grow the bottom line, whether it's for my own business or for my client's business. And as you said, you know, going through these launches, I've done plenty of them for myself, and they are just so much work. They're heavy, they're complex, and they're difficult. And I think, I don't know about you, Lindsay, but for me, most of the time you're left feeling after the fact that all the work that went into it wasn't worth the growth that came out of it.
That is so true. And a lot of people don't realize the back end of it, right? Like the sales pages, the other web pages, the email sequences. It's like, holy Hannah, it's a lot.
There's hundreds of steps in putting these launches together. And you know, what people don't calculate when they're looking at this is the time for the staff required. And I have an internal team and I don't even want to use my own internal team for this stuff anymore. I'm like, their time is so valuable. They can be closing clients, right? So for me, I'm always looking for what's the fastest, simplest, easiest way to get to the goal. And the goal is to build your bottom line so that you can create more movement in terms of whatever your mission in the world is. It's not to have a revenue number, because there's plenty of businesses, Lindsay, that are multi-million dollar businesses where the business owner takes home less than six-figure business owners. So we need to get our heads on straight when it comes to growing our businesses and remember, why are we doing what we're doing? And are you doing it for someone else so you can project an outward image? Or are you doing it for yourself so that you can experience the lifestyle and the focus on your family and the ability to save and invest and donate to things that you care about? And that's why we started making this big change to the launch style that we're doing now.
And I love that. And it's so true, right? And everything that you do is like, let's just keep simple. And so you've based your new, I don't know if you want to call it new, but your approach to being simple and getting it done quickly. So can you elaborate how you've done your launches more organically and sort of give us an idea of what it looks like?
Yeah, absolutely. So, you know, there's so many different elements of our little ecosystem that we have going here at Kelly Roach Coaching. And you know, I'm not going to oversimplify the fact that we go hard and long at marketing all day, every day, just like you do, Lindsay, just like all good entrepreneurs do. But what we realized was that when we were attempting to do things like the sideways sales letter, like the PLF formula, even webinars, which I love webinars and I use them consistently, but I found something really interesting. And that was that all the people that were buying were the people that were in our community already anyway, meaning that the thing that was important all year long was that we were doing steady community building, steady list building every week, running our basic opt-in to build our email list and providing value to our community. But the people that were buying at the end of webinars were people already on our email list. The people buying in our launches, people already on our email list. Yeah. So I was scratching my head and saying, why are we killing ourselves doing all of this outbound advertising, all of this outbound promotion, spending tons of time and money to put on this outward facing launch when in reality, the people who are buying are the people that you've been warming up rapport with, building relationship with all along. Why not start focusing on our own people for our launches, right?
Exactly.
Yeah. So I was like, okay, what's the most powerful thing happening in marketing today? Mm-hmm. Video. Yeah. What is the element of video that is selling and that's creating sales? It's live streaming. Now, to me, I'm obsessed with live streaming for one reason and one reason only, because I suck at technology and because I like to keep things simple. And because to me, I can figure out how to push that button on the phone that says go live. Whereas like landing pages and graphics and, you know, videos and all this production, you know, that's just crazy. So I said, you know, here's what we're going to do. We're going to target our own people. So we're going to promote this internal launch to our own email list. We're going to pick a super niche topic that we know we've been hearing from people in our own community that they want, that they need. And we're just going to test this out. We're going to set up a private Facebook group. We're going to keep it open for 2 weeks. We're going to do a very similar format to what we would have done with the PLF formula or with the sideways sales letter, except we're going to do it on the fly, totally just free, fun, and fluid, where we're dialoguing back and forth with people on live stream. And the results have been astounding. We've maxed out two programs back to back inside of a month, and it was our first time on each of these programs. So it wasn't even a tested or proven thing. We just said, hey, let's test this out. Let's see what happens. It might totally bomb. And the results were amazing, more than 6 figures growth in a single month. And, you know, just by tapping into what we had been working to create all year long with our own email list.
Yeah. And you're basing it off of and spinning off of the relationships that you have with people, right? And for me, that's the really important part.
Exactly. Like the people that join the group are self-selecting and saying, I like you, I value you, I'm on your email list because I like getting your stuff. And then they're self-selecting again and they're saying, yes, I'm really interested in this super niche topic, which for us, like the two topics that we just launched programs around, one was building a side hustle. So it was for people that are working a 9-to-5 that want to build a side business. And the other was people that are writing a book that wanted to learn how to build their business in the process of getting ready to launch the book. So super niche topic. So they self-select a second time. And then you give homework and you give assignments and incentives throughout this little mini challenge that you're doing in the group. So they're self-selecting a third time. And by the time you get to the fourth day of having this group open, you pretty much already know who's buying your program. And by the time you open it up on the fourth day, within a few days of selling, you can max out a program and be adding easily, you know, 8,000 plus a month in recurring revenue to add that 6 figures to your business that who isn't looking to do that, right?
Yeah, that's awesome. And the fact that you're, you know, even those that don't sign up, you're connecting with them on a bigger level. So you're able to pull people down your sales funnel and just build better relationships with your prospects. It's like a win-win.
Oh, you have no idea. Lindsay, I cannot even believe we've never had a bigger response from our own community than we had following these two challenges where people said, thank you so much. I told my team, we already have a full waiting list of people for the second book intensive.
Nice.
So it's what you said, Lindsay, is a huge highlight of the whole thing, because when people are just getting emailed these launch videos in email, I mean, who reads their email anymore anyway? I'm just like, delete, unless it's an email from my team about a critical issue, or it's them setting me up to talk with a prospect or something. I'm like, delete. And we all are, because we're just too busy. Whereas, you know, in Facebook, it's a captive audience. They've reserved their time, and they said, you know what? I'm going to relax. I'm going to do something for me. I'm going to play on Facebook for a little bit. I'm going to tune in. I'm going to learn something. And so they're really getting 10 times more value because they're so much more present there with you.
Absolutely. You have their undivided attention, right? And it's like instant interaction back and forth. It's not waiting for someone to do something, see if they did it, and then follow up with them. You know what I mean? It's that for sure is speed, but it's like that instant gratification, that instant engagement. And to just to have anyone's undivided attention is like gold.
Well, absolutely. And going back to how this not only will fill your programs today, but sets up the waiting list for the next round tomorrow, you know, when you show up and you're live with someone, you're answering their questions on the spot, you're dialoguing back and forth with them, that creates faster progress down the sales funnel in 5 minutes than you could have done in a year of pre-populated emails.
Absolutely.
And it takes little effort to sit and hit live, right?
I know. And I think it establishes more trust too, because they, you know, you're answering their questions off the cuff. You clearly know your stuff when you're answering them that quickly. It's not scripted. Do you know what I mean?
Yes.
And you're connecting with someone. So you're building a relationship with them. I know some people think you can't build relationships with people online, but I disagree.
I totally disagree. And I think, in fact, that is the beginning of most great business relationships at this point. I mean, eventually, maybe you'll connect one-on-one at some point. But a lot of times people are going right from watching your live stream to joining your group program, and your first one-to-one or even, you know, group interaction with them offline on a phone call is after they've joined that program. Mm-hmm. But they feel such a sense of connection with you and such rapport because of that time that they've now spent with you. I mean, I can't believe the outpouring of people that we had reach out and thank us after we ran these challenges just for the free stuff that they learned that they put into practice right away, which that's the whole point.
Yeah, absolutely. So you only have this group open for 2 weeks, right? So you just close it out at the end and then they just stay connected with you on Facebook?
Yeah. So basically, and there's a really specific reason why I did that, and it's not necessarily for everyone. So I'll share my reason for doing that. And I think each person and each business has to decide what's right for them. So I already have 4 paid groups for 4 different programs that I have to tend to and go live in and support clients in. And so for me, I was very sensitive to the fact that I didn't want to sign up for something that I was going to need to be present in and not really able to deliver all year long, knowing that it was not the core everyday business. This was super niche content that I was creating by request. So both of these programs formed out of people coming to us and saying, hey, do you offer anything on this? Hey, I need help with that. Hey, you know, I'm not right for this program, but do you have anything for that? So we didn't initiate, we weren't like, hey, let's come up with 2 brand new programs to launch this spring. That wasn't the plan, but our own audience was saying, we want this, we need this, can you serve us? And so we're like, yeah, heck yeah, we can serve you. But I didn't want to commit to something that I wasn't going to be able to follow through on. And so I set it up this way from the beginning. But I actually believe, Lindsay, that's a big reason why it was so successful, because we only gave people 3 days to join the group.
Yeah.
Challenge started, group was closed, and we let everyone know, watch these videos now because this group is closing in 5 days. You have 5 days to consume this content and take action and learn what you came here to learn. So I think there was just this huge amount of inertia that happened as a result of the speed, which got people to take action during the challenge that then led to them saying, oh my gosh, like, I don't want to stop this. I want to continue this progress.
Yeah.
I'm jumping on board. I'm joining the program.
Absolutely. It creates a ton of urgency because otherwise people, oh, I'll get to that later. And you know, life takes on, right?
Exactly. And so, yeah. So then we invite those people to all make sure that they've clicked to follow, you know, to get notifications on the main business page for when we go live. And they're all on our email list. So, you know, we always are inviting people to participate in this or participate in that. And there will be things throughout the year. But I think the decision for everyone listening about, do you start a prospect Facebook group that you're going to just build and build and build, which there is certainly nothing wrong with that. There's people doing amazing things with that. You know, that versus do you do a pop-up? I think the pop-up serves two purposes. You know, one, if you really truly can't fully commit to it on an ongoing basis, that's something to consider.
Yeah.
And two, if what you're doing is a super niche topic that you are only pulling out a small segment of your community and your audience, it's not for everyone.
No, whereas, I think it's a great idea. I mean, I find niching down, especially when you're teaching something specific, you're attracting your perfect avatar, right?
Yes.
As opposed to people that are like, not tire kickers, but you know, if it's general business, and they may not show up. You want people that are interested, that are qualifying themselves, that are, you know, that's their thing. They want that and they're going to go after it. So they're going to be more action takers.
Absolutely. No, you're 100% right on that. And, you know, I just think obviously, like, and I said this in my live stream that I did on this, you know, the other day, you know, I don't know where things are going to be in 6 months. That's why I don't do a lot of live stream on tactic. I usually focus on strategy because tactics are changing so much so fast. But when I saw how quickly and how powerfully this was, and that I was like, I have to on the rooftops, like, everybody listening, go do this right now. You know what I mean? I want to get it while it works because I don't know how long it's going to work for. You know what I mean?
True, true. I love that. No, you're very giving and very sharing. And yeah, I think this is a powerful strategy. So, and I'll definitely put the live Facebook that you did actually on the show notes so that we can kind of link the two together because I think it's really powerful.
Thanks, Lindsay. That's awesome. Yeah, I mean, I really tried to get as much into those, you know, 30 minutes as I possibly could so that someone watching, if they wanted to do it, got enough that they could go to action.
No, that was perfect. And so how can people find out more about you? I mean, I know there's so much more that you can help people with in, you know, skyrocketing their sales and growing their team and, you know, boosting their bottom line.
Yeah, thanks, Lindsay. Well, my podcast is called Unstoppable Success Radio, and we have 3 shows a week, and it's completely focused on helping entrepreneurs and business owners go further, faster, and accomplishing their financial and business goals. So you can always check out the show. And my home on the web is kellyroachcoaching.com, and there are 9 different free trainings right there on the homepage where you can learn about mindset, marketing, sales growth, team building, all those great things that we all need to focus on to get to our business goals.
Awesome. Well, I'm so excited about your success with your pop-up launch groups. I think that is absolutely amazing. And I know you are helping a ton of your clients. So yeah, thank you so much for sharing that with us.
Yeah, this is fun. Thanks, Lindsay.
Alrighty. So folks, this week's 15-minute cruise to move the needle in your business has come to an end. I know it goes by fast. And I want, of course, thank again the lovely Kelly Roach. So if you are looking to achieve faster growth through blogs, videos, podcasts, social, and all that is content marketing, then look no further than smoothbusinessgrowth.com. So have a profitable and productive week, folks, and may the winds always be at your back.